Hey, welcome back. It's Dr. Ko from Reset Ketamine in Palm Springs, and I came across a really interesting article recently. It was published in Nature Communications in May 2022, and the title of this article is Ketamine Activates Adult-Born Immature Granule Neurons to Rapidly Alleviate Depression-like Behaviors in Mice. All right, so that's kind of a mouthful, so let me just kind of break it down for you. In this study, they took mice because they were going to be dissecting the brains, and you don't want to do that on a human being. So they gave these groups of mice doses of intravenous ketamine. And what they found in their studies was that the mice who received the ketamine, a very specific portion of the brain called the hippocampus, in that area of the mice's brain, they found increased neurogenesis. So what that means is, if you break down the word neurogenesis, neuro referring to the brain, genesis referring to creation or birth, it actually increased neurogenesis inside of that hippocampus region. Now, one of the things that we're finding is that people who suffer from depression actually may have a degeneration of that portion of the brain. So we wonder, what is causing ketamine to work so rapidly? How is this antidepressant effect working so, you know, within 1, 2, 3, 4 days versus some standard SSRI treatments, which can take weeks to months to kick in? And the researchers hypothesize that it is because of ketamine's effect in the hippocampus causing neurogenesis to help rapidly alleviate depression. So again, this is a study done on mice, so it may not be 100% applicable to humans, but because we're not going to be dissecting the brains of humans, this would be a fair metaphor or analogy to what is going on inside of the human brain. Now, moving beyond neurogenesis, one of the other important things is something called integration. So if new neurons are being formed and developed and generated, and new synaptic connections and dendrites are forming, what are you going to do with those new neurons? What are you going to do with those new synaptic connections? Well, this is where action takes precedence. You really need to take action after the ketamine therapy to get maximal effects. So one of the interesting things that I've noticed with our patients, that it's not just the ketamine that seems to help them the most, but it's actually the actions that they take afterwards. So for example, someone may say, hey, I'm gonna start exercising. Someone may say, hey, I'm gonna take a break from alcohol. Someone may say, hey, I'm gonna take a break from marijuana or whatever it is. Another person may say, hey, I'm gonna start bicycling more. Another person may say, I'm gonna start meditating. So these integration actions are really crucial to maximize the benefit of ketamine, and in particular with neurogenesis. Let me know what you think about this. Leave me any questions, comments, and I will see you in the next video.